Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from group 10 and our discussion today is about quizzing the other reading and writing Indigenous Australian Jim R. Martin. Before we jumping to the material, let me introduce our group member in this group. So the first speaker is myself, Krisna Nuryanti, and the second speaker is Sri Hastuti, and the last speaker is Nuranisa Sahra. So in this presentation, there will be a 3 points. There are modern initiatives, postmodernist intervention, and transdisciplinary reading and writing. Okay, let me explain the first material. So Bernstein's work on pedagogic discourse in 1990 to 1996 and Holliday's systematic functional linguistics in 1994 have proved fruitful partners for this kind of because of their ongoing concern with issues of language and education. So the next material will be modern initiative. So Merck comment that the most obvious history to write is the one which celebrate the achievements of the powerful using the language of the powerful by Betterack ATAL in 1984 or 1996. P143, a practice was characterized as a form of denial which engenders a complicity with all that has gone before. The past is concealed, and the living become accomplished in the continuation of injustice in 1991, P259. Elision of this kind has been a long-standing concern in critical discourse analysis, or CDA, and is pursued in some detail for the discipline of history in Martin and Woodard, or forthcoming. A useful place to start is Frank Hardy's well-known 1968 account for the work of the unlucky Australians. Hardy makes recount for Aboriginal people to tell what happened in their own words, with Hardy writing down their stories. As we can see, Hardy preserved many of the features of linguist Aboriginal English, commenting on the spelling as follows. The Gurindji language has no F or V sounds, so they substitute P and B for these when they talking English. No doubt some editing has taken place in the transcription process. This cannot be a completely faithful rendering of spoken language, as anyone who has written down recorded speech will recognize. But the normalization process has taken place is certainly comparable to the Hardy uses for speakers of standard English in his book, Normalizing False Stars, Repetition, Interjection, and the like. Okay, I think that's all from me. The next material will be brought to you by Sri Hastuti. So Sri Hastuti, time is yours.
Okay, I'd like to talk about postmodernist intervention. From this evaluation, we can perhaps see that reading state has a different origin from the text we have considered so far. Indeed, Ross 1996 and Ross and Clark 1997 in a way referred to the Muick archives. Although they are concerned with tracing indigenous knowledge in the Australian landscape, a project that views naive linguists like myself as closely linked to Link to reading combine the sides of the stats. Okay, next, Mewks' defense of the theory illustrates his point. One reader who will fall prey to the text, seduced by its movements, reach breathless and moving conclusion, ready for action and debate on the issues most pressing for our survival in this country. The subsequent fragments may seem too theoretical to some, but in my opinion, theory is not all abstract. Theory, the available framework in which certain questions and assumptions are allowed, and certain statements emerge in this way, they have concrete effects. Thank you. I think that's all from me. Next, I back to the moderator.
Okay, and the last speaker is Nuranisa Zahra. Time is yours.
Okay, I want to tell you about transdisciplinary reading and writing. In this chapter, I have used systematic functional linguistics and social semiotics to analyze modernist and post-structuralist receptions of the voice of indigenous people in Australia. Functional linguistics is used to analyze the language used to introduce other sound, the types of projection and metadiscourse use, and the type extension that connect one sound to another, elaboration or extension. MDA is used to consider the use of image in relation to this verbal material. One thing that has become the focus of attention on imagery is the importance of graphology as a research for predicting the indigenous voice in the text that otherwise encompass the other. It is important to note that the MDA used by MC Gregor and myself was designed by Kress and Van Leeuwen, based on Halliday's systematic functional analysis of English grammar. We have got a glimpse of the discourse on reconciliation in Australia here, which focuses on representation from the journey of Red Hill and the Paddy Road. As far as voting for indigenous Australian is concerned, we can already see the different disciplines involved: writer, historian, anthropology, linguistic, and cultural studies. And usually, writer and editor play more than one role at a time, Hardy as writer and historian, Ross as historian and anthropology, Moose as linguistic and cultural theorist. This analysis might itself be a composite analysis involving analysis of language and image and other modality as they arise. Involving social linguistic and semiotic as this discipline are now understood. One thing I'm trying to suggest here as far as interdisciplinary view on interdisciplinary initiative it's concerned is that we see positive developments on sites where people are trying to make the world a better place, alongside as more familiar. Semiotic deconstruction for enforcing hegemony at this type of crisis and anthropology malaise around the world. One thing we need to remember in evaluating this strategy is that no matter our direct or indirect approach, the text still has potential meaning. It will be picked up and read in different ways according to the social subjective involved. Ross strategy is a supportive one. It's texture, interpretation, paraphrase, and illustration. For a break from our culture to their effect, it were to exhibit to fed to sympathy, maybe empathy, out of respect, maybe understanding. This is of course paternalistic, But perhaps the outlook of charity is the best that mainstream Australia can manage in this reactionary time. Looking for a hit, our strategy doesn't really involve Ghanaian dialect for that we need other possibilities, including where indigenous voice speak to us. Okay, I think that's all for me. Back to you.
Okay, thank you. So I think that's all for our presentation today. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.